Sarmatians are Aryan sort of in their native element. And so it's a kind of interesting transtemporal experiment, if you can imagine, like taking these people and putting them out in the American West, again, away from the centers of civilization in Europe, and seeing them revert to their native mode of being, right? So in a way, like the American cowboy and the strong American frontiers woman is very similar to the Sarmatian of ancient times.
Well, it's fascinating, Jason, because I would imagine most of our viewers maybe never even heard of the Sarmatians until now, and yet we can see they had an enormous influence on our notion of chivalry, our notion of romance, our notions concerning magic, and even I'm thinking of the process philosophy of Alfred North Whitehead, which is a very important modern philosopher, who probably derived influence from Heraclitus.
Yes, and Heraclitus was the most revered thinker for Nietzsche, who said that the maxim of Zarathustra's people, Zoroaster's people's maxim, was to speak the truth and shoot well with arrows. He says that is Persian virtue. Well, it's actually more Sarmatian virtue than it is Persian virtue, because Artemis means truth, the immortal, or immortal truth. Artemis is a contraction of arta, truth, or right order, and amesha, or immortal. So, you know, the cowboys who say out in the American West, be a straight shooter, which doesn't just mean, you know, be a good shot. It also means speak the truth, because you fear nothing from anyone. They, again, parallel this Scythian and Sarmatian attitude toward life. Speak the truth and shoot well with arrows.
Jason Reza Georgiani, once again, a very enlightening conversation.
Thank you, Jeffrey. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you for being with me, and thank you for being with us.